We thought when we heard these tanks to our rear, oh, the Germans have outflanked us from Bastogne. We were not too far from Bastogne. And when we saw the first Sherman tank, we said, oh, they're ours, they're ours. And as a result, when they pulled in, of course, the hatch was down because hostile territory. And then we knew, if you ever get in front of that tank, you're done. But we knew that if we could just get one of those grenades into the tank treads and blow it off, you know, and just go around the ring, or if we could get in the back where the ventilators were, and that's where a bazooka would come in, because the Tiger tank at the front was just invincible. You know, you just really couldn't knock a Tiger tank out from the front. And Patton learned that a long time before a lot of other generals did, that you don't go face to face with a Tiger tank versus a 36-ton Sherman. You get around the back. But serving under Patton, that is a psychological experience that I will never, never forget. He would turn up at the darndest places in just a lacquered helmet liner and pearl-handled pistols, just as if he was, you know, braving. And he did something to kids. You know, you didn't too often see many generals up at the front, except in an airborne operation. It was interesting that the two airborne divisions faced about 80,000 German troops that were trying to get in so they could block the Rhine. It was the bloodiest single day in airborne history when we went in on Operation Varsity, March 24th, 1945. But it was the most successful. Boy, when the shelling would come in and we'd call medic, it was unbelievable. Those kids went out of the safety of their hole and rendered on to the guy that was wounded. Last bayonet charge of the ETO. And I was able to at least take the artillery fire up. But then those kids had to take the last of that with the bayonet. So that's why the slaughter, it really was a slaughter in a Battle of the Bulge. 2 hours maybe into my sleep, I wakened myself, sobbing convulsively. It was the first time I could, not that you don't feel that you could mourn, all those kids alongside of you, that, and so it was so strange. You know, we didn't know everybody, but we would lay down our lives if necessary for each other, and it was just an intangible that was indescribable. I'm so disappointed about the fact that history teachers will allow history to be dull. Whenever a kid says, oh, it's so boring, you know, it just cuts me to the core, because it said, what kind of history are you learning? Not that you glorify war or anything of that sort, but you have to know that what you have today here in America is a result of kids that were willing to lay down their lives and that we're not doing. We're really not doing that. Freedom isn't free. Freedom has cost so much in our own history that people must realize that the sacrifices that had to be made in order for this to occur, that's the theme of so many of our guys when we meet, is not the glory of the whole thing, but the fact that we contributed the best we could toward this prize of freedom. And it's maybe intangible for some, but for us it's real. For the veterans and for the families, The cost is awesome. The emblem of that flag flying is just unbelievable. That banner, that star-spangled banner, is not an abstract thing that we just fly without thinking. It's a symbol of all the bravery that has occurred in supporting and leading our country and making it what it is.